Joining us is ER Doc Jay Mack. Dr. Mack, welcome to the show.
Thanks. It's good to be here. I wish I was here for a more uplifting episode.
So tell us, what happens to the human body during a crowd surge that we've been talking about during the course of the show?
So there are three things at play here. There's the crowd surge, which is when you get so many people densely packed in a small area, the whole crowd begins to move almost as a liquid, more of a liquid than individual human beings. There's then crowd crush, when the weight of all these people end up compressing the chests of the individual concert goers. And then there's crowd collapse, where if somebody falls down, almost like pulling, unclogging the drain in a bathtub, all of the people end up falling in towards that hole, and a dog pile is then created and the person on the bottom.
Scary. So yeah. Doc, what are some life-saving tips you can share for people if they ever find themselves in a situation like this? And you know, these crowd situations, I mean, concerts, yes, but this could happen in other scenarios, tight places where there's panic.
Right, absolutely. And here are four things that you can do to potentially survive. Get your arms up. One of the biggest killers in this situation is asphyxiation. If your chest wall can't expand, you can't respirate, right? And if you can't expel carbon dioxide, your carbon dioxide levels rise, you get lightheaded, you get confused, you pass out, your oxygen levels drop, you don't get any oxygen to your brain. We all know what happens then. The second thing you need to do is to go with the flow. Yeah. The amount of force that ends up going through this crowd is not something that one individual can push back against. So you need to save your energy. It's pointless to fight it. Three, try to stay upright. It's easier said than done, but try to focus on your center of gravity as you go with the flow, because if you fall down, we heard the eyewitness accounts from earlier, it is nearly impossible to get back up. And then you can have the crowd collapse where people start dogpiling on top of you. So do everything you can to stay on your feet. The last thing, and again, we don't have a lot of control over this, but try to stay away from hard surfaces, those barriers, those walls. Unless you can get over those, imagine the force of 50,000 people compressing against you, and then that force can't be further transmitted. It ends up getting pushed right back into you, breaking ribs, potentially injuring your spine. It's not the place to be.
Thank you so much for these really potentially life-saving tips in an unruly crowd scenario. Thank you.
I had no idea about the hands up. That alone, right? Just things you just never think. Great tips.
Right. Yeah, you think about being in the middle of a crowd and having your arms compressed at your sides or up in the air. That's not where you want them. You got to think like a boxer. Get those arms up.
Great tips, Dr. Mack.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. It was an honor to be here.